Tell me dealing with the stress, tell me dealing with the pain. Getting tired, trying to find a way, cause I just wanna be alive. Cause I don't think that I just wanna go and die today. When I used to think to myself, yeah, why am I this way? Then I found out that I am a champion. Now I'm rising up in this light. I'm a champion, I'm a rise, but I'm never gonna give up. I don't care what the pep.
Hi, friends.
Hey, hey, hey. What's going on, lady?
What's up, Sunday folks?
Hey, Lori.
Hello, hello.
Hi. I'm sitting here with a good close friend of mine. And we were just having a discussion. So I apologize that I am a little tardy for the party. Y'all having a good Sunday?
Yes, ma'am.
Right. So look, I wanted to give you guys just a quick tidbit before the week gets started. All right. Lori Woodruff, for those that may not know who I am. I definitely want to give it back to Daniel Bethay, who's going to be giving you guys some good nuggets today on support and resistance. So this is a time that on Sundays, I know that we like to get together to make sense of what trading is all about. So make sure you take notes. And I just wanted to invite you to make sure that you take a look at the calendar on mytradinglounge.com. Tomorrow. And then you make sure you check out a look and see what's going on for the week. Daniel and I are in the process of updating the calendar so that not only just the calendar, but also the website. Because many people, we have to expand. And we're going to make sure that we have the resources for some HFX and the binary options, trading options for you guys. So we're in the process of getting that updated. So Dan, what do you think, by the middle of the week?
Well, everything else is pretty much up and running. I just got finished updating the website this morning. The HFX information should be done by the end of today. So if you guys will look back on it tomorrow morning, you'll be good to go.
He's fast. All right. Awesome. Thank you. So that way you'll have some Forex, regular standard Forex information. And remember, HFX is still Forex trading, but it's a different style. It's just a different style. So we're going to make sure we have that on the mytradinglounge.com site. So I don't want to make sure that you guys are confused. That's not an affiliate of the IM Dot Center with IM Mastery. That's just our personal team. Resource of information so we can keep everybody updated. You fine folks, little sexy folks out there, y'all need to know. And then the last thing, and I just want to welcome you and welcome your guest to the Harmonic Scanner Money in Minutes, which is going to be Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, 8:30 a.m. every morning. So yeah, we're still holding good with that. Yes, so you guys are doing great. Check the calendar out. You guys have an amazing class. And me and this dude right here, we're going to get back to work. Okay? We're doing some videos. And I think it's time.
It's time.
If y'all know the story behind the watch, then you'd understand the joke. But I want you guys to have a wonderful week. You guys have a great training session. Dan, take it away, sir.
All right. Guys, so like I said earlier, we're going to deep dive into this thing. All right, so let me go ahead and share my screen. We're going to be talking about that support. We're going to be talking about that resistance. And we're going to make sure that everybody knows exactly how to mark up their charts, how to mark up their zones, because this is going to be key to your success. Understanding exactly where the market is really going or where she is really trying to go. You need to be able to understand your levels of support, your levels of resistance, and how to mark up your zones. So what we're going to do, let me just go ahead and share my screen. Let me make sure that everybody can see my screen. Can everybody see my screen? Drop some ones in the chat group if you can. All right. Beautiful. So we got GU up here on the charts right now. We got GU up on the charts. All right. Now, one of the things that we talked about earlier on last week, we talked about Elliott's Wave, right? And we also talked about the head and shoulder pattern. So what I want to do real quick is just do a quick review, all right? just for individuals who may not necessarily have been on the last couple of sessions, but Elliott's Wave, very, very simple, easy to follow. But what we're going to be focusing on is those pullbacks, all right? So understand, the market moves up, and it just moves up in waves, all right? So when she has an impulsive move, the next move is that pullback. Typically, it pulls back about 50% of that first impulsive move. Then what she does is she actually goes up approximately about the same exact distance as your previous impulsive move. Then she pulls back down to that level of support. Okay, almost 50% of the impulsive move, and then she moves up one more time. This is being your fifth wave. So you have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Once she actually hits her fifth wave, then the market starts to reverse and go in the opposite direction. Okay, so notice market pulls down. She shifts back up about 50%. Okay, and notice this is 0, 1, 2. This will be 3. Market pulls up. This will be 4. Market shoots back down, and that will be 5. Okay, now, as you can notice, you have a left shoulder, you have a head, and then you have a right shoulder. This is the top portion of the Elliott's Wave, okay? This is a regular head and shoulder pattern. Now, once the market comes down here to this low, she turns around and she does the complete opposite. She shifts back up after her fifth move, shifts back down, about 50%, give or take. And then she shifts back up. She starts to wave all over again. Okay, she starts to wave all over again. She pulls down about 50%, and then she continues to move on up. Now, here is the caveat. Here's the deal. Notice you have a head and shoulder pattern at the top of this, and you have an inverted head and shoulders at the bottom of this. But we're not going to be talking about the head and shoulder pattern today. What we're going to be focusing in on is our zoning, our levels of support, and our levels of resistance, okay? But what I want to do is I want to show you how all of this merges in together, okay? Notice when the market moves up, she pulls back about 50%. This is where you place your horizontal line, right here at the base of where the market pulled back to, okay? Notice how you have on the opposite side of that wave, okay? The market came back down and supported that same position here and here before the market pushed back up. Every time that you see a pullback, all you're going to do is place a line directly underneath that pullback. That's all you're doing, guys. That is all you're doing. Even on the opposite side, notice all you're doing is placing, because this is going in a downward direction, right? All you're doing is placing horizontal line directly on top or on the bottom of that pullback. That becomes your level of support, and that becomes your level of resistance. Really simple. That becomes your level of support, and that becomes your level of resistance. Now, your zoning is when you use a rectangle tool to capture that entire line, okay? So what we do is we just take our same line that we placed in for our level of support resistance, and all we're doing is just placing a rectangle around that area. That is all we are doing. Because what we're anticipating is the market to come back into that area before she shifts and go in the opposite direction. Okay? Same thing here. All we're doing We're looking for that market to come back into that zone, and we analyze the market once she's in that zone to see exactly what direction she's going to continue to move. All right? So all we're doing, like I said, is we're using our rectangle tool to determine, give me 1 second, get rid of that. All we're doing is using our rectangle tool to map out a nice little zone where we need to analyze the market now to see if she's going to reverse or she's going to give us a continuation. Okay. So we're looking for a reverse in that zone, or we're looking for a continuation. This is the area in which you want to start paying attention to your candlestick patterns. Now, on Saturday, if you were not out in the class, guys, you missed a great class. You really missed a great class. We talked about the candlestick patterns. We talked about what the candlesticks were. We talked about certain indicators that you can use, but price action is key. All right, price action is key. So you want to understand exactly how to read your candlesticks. You want to know how to read your candlesticks. And if you don't know how to read your candlesticks, we just sent out a candlestick Bible to, and we actually posted it on the website. So therefore, if you have not gone to mytradinglounge.com, go out to mytradinglounge.com and go to the resources tab, and you will actually see the candlestick Bible out there. All right, now, zoning is very, very simple. It is very simple. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over here to the candlesticks. All right. I'm going to go to the candlesticks because what I want you guys to see, a lot of times you will not see, okay? You won't see your levels of support and you won't see your levels of resistance. It's literally an imaginary line that's just going through your candlesticks. But we have a numerous amount of ways to actually figure out where your levels of support and levels of resistance are. But the easiest way to determine that, I want you to come up here where it says candles, right next to the little compare. Click on that and come down to your line chart. Now, why am I turning on my line chart? Because it kills all the noise. I don't need to see any candlesticks, you know, wicks or anything. All I need to do is see the line. And what I am looking for, this is all I'm looking for. These sharp points like this. That's what I'm looking for right there. Sharp points. This is all I'm looking for. My sharp points right there, right there, right here. Okay, right there. I'm looking for those sharp points. And why am I looking for those sharp points? Because that's where the market reversed on us. That's where the market basically say, hey, I've reached a level of support or I've reached a level of resistance. It's time for me to reverse. It's time for me to go in the opposite direction. That's what this is. Okay, now. What did we say before? What are we going to do? We're going to grab us a horizontal line, right? We're going to grab a horizontal line, and we're just going to place it on that level. Notice that a market came here, bounced, and then pushed through. Bounced here, bounced there, came back down, broke through, but retested and dropped. Market came back up to this level, dropped, back up to this level, dropped, broke through, and she just basically bounced in this area. Now, here is the beautiful thing. If I turn on my line chart, I'm going to turn off my line chart and go back to my candlestick pattern, you'll see how that market disrespected that area. You see wicks, 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 wicks. All right, you see wicks. The market respected that level. This is how I actually go through and find my different levels of support and my levels of resistance. I just simply turn on my line chart. That's it. And I look for my sharp points. That's it. So when you're looking to zone, the first thing that you want to do, you want to turn off your candlestick patterns or your candlesticks and turn it to the line chart. Now you can easily cut out the noise and find your true levels of support and your levels of resistance, just simply using your sharp points. So down here, this is a level. All right, I'm gonna try to line everything up here. Okay. You have another level about right here. Okay. Like I said, all we're doing is looking at our sharp points. Okay. So now, once we have our levels, all we're doing, let me put this one here as well. Okay. All we're doing at this point is grabbing our rectangle tool, okay? And then we're just putting a rectangle around that line. All right? That's all we're doing. That is all we are doing. And notice how if we stretch it all the way out, okay? It respected that level so many different times.
So Daniel, I have a question for you. So that when you put the rectangle in there, it doesn't have to be a specific width or anything?
I don't necessarily care for a specific width. Okay. You know, everybody has a different way of doing it. Uh-huh. I'm just looking for that particular area for the market to come back to that particular area.
Okay.
That's all I'm really looking for. You can have it as fat as you want, small as you want. My rule of thumb is just make it nice and neat. That's it. Now I like to actually give it just enough room. You know what I mean? Just a nice little size as far as thickness is concerned, but nothing, you know, saying wild and crazy. That's it.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Now, this is something that I've actually learned from Oren. I think this was 5,000. What's it? Oh, wrong way, wrong direction. And that actually maximizes and pushes everything all the way out if you need be, all right? Now, like I said, all you need is...
Sorry, would you do that again, Daniel?
Oh, okay. I'm going to show you.
The rectangle coordinate.
Yeah. So what you can do is you can kind of go into the coordinates just to kind of get everything to shift all the way over without you having to drag everything all the way over. So just double click on it and go down to your coordinates. And then at the second one where it says price bar, it's going to come all the way over, erase everything, and just type out 5,000. All right. And then what they'll do is that'll shift everything over until it reaches the end of your chart. Okay. Let me do this one here, 1,000.
Thanks.
Oh, not a problem. Now, I'm gonna do this one down here too. And then we're going to do this last one. And I just want you guys to see how the market basically has just been bouncing between these levels, right? That's all I really want you guys to see. Market bouncing between these levels. And I'm going to show you a technique that a friend of mine showed me. Really simple. Because market tends to come back 50% of whatever zone that it's in. Okay, so notice, market pushes up, she comes back down to the zone, and pushes up again until what? She reaches the top. Market pushes back down, but then shifts up into the next zone. Once she reaches her level of resistance, she pushes back down to the level of support. Once she gets here, she breaks through. She breaks through the second level of support, comes back up to retest, and then what? Drops down to the next level of support. So the market is doing nothing but going from one zone to the next. But understand, when it reaches your zone, this is an opportunity for you to go and check the lower time frames to see exactly what the market is doing so you can take advantage of the trade opportunity, okay? So let's take, for example, this area here. What we're gonna do, I'm going to, and this is on a 4-hour time frame, okay? We'll put a black line right there. We're gonna turn our candlesticks back on. All right. What do we see? What are some things that we see? Somebody talk to me. What are some of the key?
An engulfing candle.
Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. So we see an engulfing candle, right? Yep. And she's pushing away from that zone. So what direction should the market be going?
Bearish.
Bingo. In a bearish direction. All right. So if she's going in a bearish direction, we're putting in a sell and we just letting this market drop. What is our target?
13,132.60.
There you go. We're just going from one zone to the next. Simple as that. Then we have what? Another bearish engulfing candle, right? Mm-hmm. Then we see a nice little retest. What's our next target?
129.97.
Bingo, the next level of support. And all we're doing is just taking it down. Market comes back through. After we hit our TP, she keeps going. She pushes back up. Now we have what? Another engulfing candle, right? So we got another sell opportunity here. What is our next level? What is our TP?
I see it, but I'm not going to tell you. I'm trying to give somebody else a chance, man.
It's all right. It's all right.
Go on, Deborah. You're doing good. You're doing good.
1.2783.
Right. Our next level of support. That's all this is. We're just going from one support level to the next. And do you see how once it actually gets into this area, we have contraction, we have consolidation, but then we have a breakout opportunity here. All right. Look at how the market breaks out, comes back over, retests a little bit, and then she pushes right on back up, right back to that zone. And then she drops down about 50% of that zone and then pushes back up again until she's what? Doing what? Breaking through that support and now coming back over to retest again. And it looks like she just continues to push up after that. Okay. So what I'm going to show you guys. All right. This is something that I actually learned from my friend Ricardo. Look, you don't have to be greedy in order to get your money. I want you guys to understand that. You don't have to be greedy in order for you to make your money. Okay? This is something that Ricardo actually taught me. You're just going from one zone to the next, right? Mm-hmm. That's all you're doing. You're just going from one zone to the next. So what he does is he uses his pips. But there's not a lot of levels that he has on his pips. The only levels that he has on his pips is your 1, your 50, and your 0. That's the only levels that he has on his pips. And this is all he does.
Okay, got it.
He just goes from one zone to the next. Just marking up that 50% line. Just literally just going from one zone to the next. Marking up that 50% line. That's it. You can even come down here and do the same thing if you want. Just going from one zone to the next, marking up your 50% line. All right. Now, understand, I'm on a 4-hour chart, okay? But I want you to see this. You have an engulfing candle. Market pushes out. She's practically at your 50% line at this moment, okay? So this is probably a trade that I probably would not have actually taken if I'm looking at the strategy in which Ricardo actually showed me. So we wait until this market gets down here. She breaks through, comes back up to retest. At this point, this is where I'm getting in as a sell. Okay, because I see the retest and I see an engulfing candle that's pushing down. All right. So from this point here, or should I say, I'm just saying here. So from this point here to here, that's how many pips? $131, right? Are you comfortable with 131 pips?
Absolutely.
Yep.
Okay. So you got 131 pips, possible profit. All he's doing is entry is here. Stop loss is at the previous high. And his target is at the 50% line. That's a 1-to-2 ratio. Are you comfortable with that? That's 119 pips from what it looks like. 119 pips total. Are you comfortable with that?
Mm-hmm.
Now, there's a second one, all right? You see the market break through. We have an engulfing candle here. All he's doing is going from zone to zone. That's it. He's not doing anything different. I mean, he's just marking off, setting his stop loss at the previous high. That is your previous high. And all he's going is to where?
The 50.
The 50. That's it. This one here is a total of what? How many pips? 95 pips. That's a 1-to-2 ratio. Now, watch this. Okay, I'm gonna delete this. Get rid of this here. Now, when the market gets down to this zone here, we see consolidation happen, but we understand we have a couple of wicks, right? So the market is doing what? Is he shifting back up or is he shifting down?
Consolidating.
Mm-hmm. This is all he's doing. This is all he's doing. And he's going where? Back to the 50. Mm-hmm. He's just playing ping pong, guys. That's all he's doing. He's just playing ping pong from one zone to the next. From one zone to the next. All he's doing is just going 50%. That's it. That's absolutely it. That's 99 pips that you can acquire. Are you comfortable with 99 pips? Are you comfortable with 119 pips?
Absolutely.
Yes, yes. Yes.
This is the importance of understanding how to mark up your zones. This is the importance of how to understand how to set your support and your resistance. Because like when he told me that he's been murdering the market just by going from one zone to the next and just going 50%, I thought he was absolutely crazy. But this man is paying off bills. He's purchasing cars. The whole nine yards, just going 50%. He don't need a lot. He's just going 50%, marking up his zones. Going from one zone to the next. All he's doing is looking for the confirmation. That's it. He's just looking for the confirmation.
I guess he's doing a standard.
Standard. I don't know if he's doing standard or not, but from my understanding, he's still in the market.
I got you.
Yeah. So all it is just, simply put, we're going to mark up our zones first. And look, this works with just about any pair. It doesn't necessarily matter what pair it is. I'm going to clear this off. We're going to go to another pair. Somebody give me a pair.
GJ.
Done. All right. I'm going to clear GJ off. We're going to set this auto, okay? Now, one of the things that he likes to do, he likes to go to the higher time frames first. He likes to go, say, to his daily time frame and then kind of shift down to the 4 hour. Me, whatever time frame I'm on, I'm just going to go ahead and just mark up those zones. It doesn't necessarily matter to me, but nonetheless, we're going to do this, all right? We're going to look at the daily. Now I'm going to find my high point. This is my high point. Step number one. All right. Actually, step number one really is turn on your line chart. That's number one. We're going to find our low point, which is right here. Okay. And then what we do is we find those areas of support and resistance where the market shows consistency. Like this here, we have 3 points where that market has basically hit. We have a hit over here, and now we have a hit over here, okay? We have here as well. See how that market hit here, here, broke through, but came back and retested here, here, and even over here, okay? Coming down here. Market bounce. And look like she just continued to move up. Now, I have four zones. And all I'm doing now is just taking my rectangle tool. Just bring that up a little bit. All right. And all I'm doing is just basically giving it a nice little area. Don't have to be too big. And we just zone everything up. We just want to give it a nice little comfortable area. You know, you don't necessarily have to make it, like I said, don't necessarily have to make it big and bulky. Just a nice little comfortable area. Because what we tend to do is we tend to look at what the market is doing in that particular area on a lower time frame. Okay? So, we have our zones.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Now, grab your hard your fibs. Let's just mark up your 50% line.
Hey, Dan, I'm sorry to interrupt you, but mm-hmm. for some reason, I can't, on TradingView, I don't see a rectangular tool.
Okay, so look at your fourth icon down. It probably looks like a paintbrush right now. Click on this arrow on the side, and that will actually give you the drop-down menu, and you'll see a rectangle tool there.
Okay, got it. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. All we're doing at this point is just marking up our 50% line. That's all we're doing. And then we're going down to the next zone. Okay. Like I said, all we're doing is just marking up our 50% line. And that's it. Just marking up that 50. Next zone. Marking up the 50. Oops. And I want you guys to notice something as well. The market is definitely respecting that 50% line
mm-hmm.
from one zone to the next. Watch it.
I'm sorry. Can you go back over how to set your percentages for the fibs?
Oh, for the fibs?
Yes.
All of this is just go on here. Anytime that you have your fibs, just open up your double click on it. And then these are going to be your settings. Okay. There's only three settings for this one. You only have your zero, your one, and your 50. So just make sure with your 50, you have a 0.5. So you want to make sure you have 0.5 in that.
When I click on my fibs, that's not what's popping up. So I'm trying to catch up. I apologize.
Okay. Not a problem. Are you on TradingView right now?
Yep.
Okay. I'll tell you what, let's talk afterwards and make sure that we get your fibs all set up. Okay.
Okay.
Riley, all his numbers are probably checked, huh?
Yeah, so you got to make sure that it's checked. You got to make sure that these are checked. If they're not checked, then they won't show up on your fibs. Okay, so if I wind up taking off this one, I'm checking the one, you see how it just disappeared, correct? But if I check it again, it reappears. So you want to make sure that everything is checked that you're going to be using. Okay. Now, one of the other things that I like to do, because I have a number of different fib levels that I like to use. So down here at the bottom, you'll see template. Okay. When you click on template, come up here to save as. This gives you an opportunity to now label that template and it will save your settings for you. That way you don't have to necessarily come back to it all the time and try to change the settings. It's automatically saved for you. Now, for me.
Thank you, Daniel. Thank you. I've been having to go back and change my every time. And I'm like, where the heck do I change it? Make me save that. Thank you.
Down here, these templates. Listen, this thing has saved my life. Saved my sanity. Because listen, anytime that I want to switch and change it up, notice how all I have to do is just click on any one of them and it just switches everything up for me. I don't have to sit back and change all the settings, it does it automatically for me. Okay.
Thank you.
You're more than welcome. All right. So we got our 50% line in place. This is simply going to be our TP, our TP levels. Okay. Your 50% line is going to be your TP levels, period. All right. What we're going to do, get rid of the fib. And now we're going to do is turn on our candlesticks again. notice. See how this market actually started shifting and going in the opposite direction? She pushed through and started shifting and going opposite direction. Where did she go? Right back down here to the 50, right? Pushed through, got down here to the very next zone. Where did she go back to? The 50.
50.
Came back down to that zone, went where?
50.
Back down. Back where? Clockwork, guys. Clockwork. She dropped, she pushes through, came right here to the 50. Pushed through the next zone, pushed right on there to the 50, pushed through all the way down here to the bottom zone. And what did she do? She ejected off of that zone and pushed right back up to the 50. Right back up to the 50. Came here.
Oh, girl.
And then dropped back to the 50 every single time. Now, if we were going from here to the 50, right now, remember, this is on a daily time frame, okay? This is on a daily time frame. Are you comfortable with 202 pips?
Yes.
Very comfortable.
Awesome. You have here.
Hey, Dan, I'm sorry. I got one more question for you.
Mm-hmm.
So you remember when you were outlining up top at the first at 1.46.137?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. And then you identified the 50% mark, which is at 1.43740, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. You just got finished identifying how it kept dropping all the way through where it got to 1.4318, and then it continued to drop and then drop to each other zone, right?
Right.
So in real time, right, because right now what I'm looking at, and I guess like in my mind, when it kept bouncing to that 50% level, going down, back up, until it finally just drop. If I place the trade and I see that the trade is wrong, then I guess what I'm going to then refocus on is the actual drop, or am I reading the actual candles?
Okay, so one thing that you can do is you can actually turn on a 50 moving average. Now, I have this thing called the Ultimate MA, and all it does is just color codes, you know, your moving average. Now, I have this one actually set to 50 moving averages. 50 moving average is nothing more than the average movement of 50 candles, okay? It's just the total average movement of 50 candles, and they mark it out using a line. So anytime that your market is underneath this moving average, you understand that you're moving in a downtrend direction, okay? So every time it breaks that zone, you can literally just stay in that particular trade until it reaches back above your 50% line, or should I say your moving average. Now, understanding that the market is just moving from one zone to the next, at this particular point when she actually bounces off of this bottom line, let me do this. Where's my vertical? Okay. And I'm gonna show you guys this, all right? We're on a daily time frame. If I go down to say the hour time frame, notice how the candlestick patterns are different. All right. But your zones are still the same. Let me see if I can. There we go. This is your bottom zone. What is the market doing? Do you see it? Consolidation. That's nothing more than consolidation. But you have a push all the way down, and then you have a push coming from that zone back over top of your moving average, and she done hit the 50% line. In this area, when she broke above your 50 moving average, this would have been a prime opportunity for you now to get out of the trade. So you've basically, I'm gonna do it this way, okay? You've basically went from this break here, okay? And I'm gonna take it from here all the way here, which you broke back above that 50% line. That's over 1,500 pips. And all you're doing is just staying in the trade until she breaks back above your 50 moving average. That's it. Understanding that the market is just going from what? One zone to the next. Look at what she did right here at your 50% line. She came down to your 50% line, bounced off of that 50% line, and then she broke down to the very next zone, back to your 50. Came back up here to your zone, bounced, and then she broke back to your 50. Guys, all it is just moving from one zone to the next. You stay with your daily. You can mark everything up on your daily time frame. Let me kind of auto this, all right? Mark everything up on your, say, your daily time frame. All you're looking for is your high point, which was here, your low point, which was here, making sure that you turn on your line chart to make sure that you're placing your line directly on top of these sharp points, okay? You're placing it directly on top of your sharp points. And then what you're gonna do is go and place another horizontal line on your areas of your support and your resistance based upon looking at your sharp points. Once you have that down, all you're doing is putting a rectangle around that line. Put a rectangle around that line. Use your fibs on the 50% to mark off half the distance between each one of these zones. Okay? Each one of these zones, you just 50% each one of the zones. You go down to a lower time frame. And now what you're doing is reading your candlestick patterns, understanding exactly what that market is doing inside that zone. That's it. And you're going to ride it from one area to the next. Now, you can even do the same thing on the hour chart if you wanted to. It's the exact same principle. Nothing changes. It's just whatever time frame that you start with, go down one or two time frames to see exactly what your candlesticks are doing so you can take advantage of that market moving from one zone to the next. And all you're doing is just going 50%. That's all you're doing. You're just going 50% to get your money. And that's it. That's absolutely it. But the market will go from one zone to the next. One zone to the next. Remember, Elliott's wave, all it's doing is just going up, pulling back 50%, and then pushing back up, coming back down 50%. And it's literally just a wave up and a wave down. And that's all this market is doing. Stair stepping, guys. It's just stair stepping. Okay? All right, so I got 4 minutes left. Anybody have any questions about what I've shown you today?
Hey, Dan, when you make your entry, are you going down? That's when you go down your two time frames, or do you go down to the five or the one to get a precise entry?
Okay, so when I actually do my entries, typically I like to look at the 1 hour time frame to see exactly where I'm at. If that market is in that particular zone like this here, okay? I like to see exactly what patterns are being shown to me. So right here, and I know some of you may not necessarily see it, but I see a bit of a head and shoulder pattern here. So what I'm looking for is that market to come back into this area here where the market actually gave me right here. I'm waiting for this market to kind of give me that signal. So when she comes back down into this area, I'm looking for that market to start to push up. So what my entry would look like off of this one, okay, This will be my entry. This right here will be my stop loss. Okay. But I'm taking this bad boy to the 50. So, risk to reward. It's a 1 to 5. Are you guys comfortable with a 1 to 5? Because all I'm risking
is
49 pips. That's 49 pips to make what? 276 pips. So, understanding your candlestick patterns, guys. Understanding your candlestick patterns, understanding the market structure patterns in itself. All you're doing is just going from one zone to the next. Now I'm gonna be covering this again later on, but what I really want you guys to understand is how to mark up your zones, okay? How to mark up your zones. And all it is, once again, you're turning everything. You go ahead and just clear everything off. First thing that you're gonna do is you're gonna just go to your chart. You're gonna turn your line chart on. I don't know why that showed up, but let me get rid of that real quick. So what you're gonna do is turn on your line chart. Find your high point. Find your low point. Okay. And then you're gonna start looking inside for areas in which you have the same equivalent of multiple touches, okay? Multiple touches. All right. See another one right here. Market bounced here, 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 even here. Come down here. See the market bounced here, 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 and here. You can even do one more down even here. Okay. So now you have multiple zones that you can use. And then you just take your rectangle tool and just give it a nice little thickness. You don't need a lot. Okay. Just like this. Now, here's a crazy thing. You can do this very same thing in a harmonic scanner. You can do the very same thing inside the harmonic scanner. Okay? But this is just a quick way to do things to get yourself prepared for the week. You know exactly what area and what zones that you are going to be trading in. All right? And then just take your fibs and just go from one zone to the next and just mark up your 50% line. And that's it. So you get this top zone.
Dan, can I ask a question?
Go ahead.
Now, based on the theory of the zones and everything, at current GJ, do you think that's a retest going up or a retest coming down? Because I'm trying to use the Elliott's wave and I can't figure out if it's at the top of the fifth or not.
Well, this one here has been a bit tricky, to be honest with you. And if you notice, right here, we got a level of what?
Support.
Right, we got a level of support. And right now she's breaking through that level of support. This is the area in which you have to be very, very careful, okay? Because sometimes what that market could do, just like she did right here, P peaked up and then turned around and dropped.
Right.
Okay. So this is where you have to pay attention to your candlestick patterns. Now, if we were to go to a lower time frame, we can see exactly what's happening in this market. Okay. I'm going to turn my candlestick patterns back on. Get rid of this fib real quick. We're going to turn our candlesticks back on. Now, what do you see? What particular patterns do you see?
I see an engulfing at that low.
Beautiful. So we see it engulfing. So we know that this market is pushing where? Up or down?
Up.
Awesome. And we also, this last candle, I can't remember what they call this particular candle, but it has a long wick at the bottom of it. I think this is what's called a hammer, actually.
Isn't that a hammer?
Yeah.
Hammer.
Mm-hmm. Typically, what happens when you have a hammer, it moves where?
Okay. Moves up.
There you go. So we have an engulfing candle pattern. You have two different engulfing candle patterns. And then this here gives us a hammer, which basically indicates that this market is now about to continue to move in an upward direction. All right, now, if we go down to, say, the 1 hour time frame, you'll see things a little differently. All right, so this is what you're looking at on the hour time frame. Market done gave us a head and shoulder pattern. She's pushed down. Now she done came back up, closed at a higher point, shift back down to our zone, and then starts to shift up.
And that was currently at that 50% of that zone.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, in between the 50 and the bottom zone.
Oh. Let's see if I'm gonna bring this down. So right now, she's right in the middle, in a sense, of the 50% line and this zone here.
Mm-hmm.
The upper zone is here. From what we were looking at on the daily, you were left with an engulfing candle and a hammer. So what we're anticipating is this market to continue to move up at least to the 50% line. Okay, now she may actually hang around in this zone, in this area here for a little bit, but what we're anticipating is this market to continue to move up to this particular area here. On an hour time frame, you have a low, a higher low, and now a higher low again. But what we don't have is a higher high. So when I look at this, and this is a little bit more advanced, okay? I'm not expecting everybody to get this, grasp this, understand this. But this is what I see. Now, this is one of the patterns that we have not talked about as of yet. Okay. But this particular pattern is an ascending triangle pattern. Market pushes up. She gets rejected several times at this same level. Pushes down, comes back up, creates a higher low, push back up to that same zone, that same area, creates another higher low. Right now, at this point, what I'm looking for is this market to basically break out and push up. So how would I particularly trade this? This will be a long for me, okay? So for me, I'm putting my entry about right here. I'm setting my stop loss at the previous low, which is about right there, okay? And then that's my target, 138 pips. Just like that. Or I can actually wait until I can just wait until this pullback happens and then set my stop loss at the end of that pullback. And I got a feeling, just looking at, like I said, your level of support and your level of resistance. I want you guys to see this. Right in here, you have rejection. But you also have rejection over here. Rejection here, here, and here. So this market could very well come back down to this point and then bounce up. So if she does, that's perfectly fine because my entry point is up here, is right here. Okay, and I have a nice little stop loss down here at the bottom, which gives me now a 1-to-3 risk to reward ratio. So now I have basically 138 pips coming to me, and all I'm risking is 38.
Got it.
Yep. And honestly, I may be putting this one in my daggone cell. All right. So listen, does anybody have any questions about what I showed you guys today?
Yeah, Dan, I have a quick question.
Okay.
For the 50% line, are you mainly using that more for a take profit?
Yes.
Or a way to use it for a take profit and a way to enter a trade?
No, I just use it for a take profit level. I don't enter into a trade until it gets back into my zone area.
Okay.
Yeah, that's the only time that I take the trade.
Okay, because you know, because when it breaks through the zone, you know it's going at least to the 50.
Correct.
Okay.
Once it leaves that zone, it gives me, you know, specific candlestick confirmations. I'm in there. Just taking it. But one of the things that you want to do is you want to make sure that you're going to the higher time frame to understand exactly what direction the market is moving.
Okay.
So you don't want to necessarily get caught in trades going in the opposite direction of what the higher time frame tells you.
Okay.
Always go along with the trend, period.
All right.
So, Dan, when you get your take profit at the current 50%, to get into the next trade, would you wait for a breakthrough and retest to take it to the actual next zone?
I am. Okay. You know, I mean, like, you could basically take it from one zone to the next.
Right.
I mean, and essentially, you can do that. But here's the deal. Some people's patience level ain't really there.
Right.
So I just recommend this to go from, you know, saying one zone to the 50%. Because the 50% is practically almost guaranteed.
So at no time, well, I know you can't predict it, but the Elliott's wave won't finish at that 50% line in between zones.
Not all the time, no.
It's gonna start or finish at the actual zones that you created.
Basically.
Because they're high and lows. I mean, swing highs and swing lows.
There you go.
Gotcha.
And she's going to go from one zone to the next, and that's it.
Gotcha.
All right.
Thanks, Dan.
Not a problem. I may have to take a look at this thing all over again, because I may be taking that trade all together.
Dan, are you going to post this recording?
Yes. I just need to get it processed or what have you, and then I'll go ahead and post it.
Okay. Thank you.
Not a problem. Yeah, now that I look at it. Yeah. What was that? Yeah, we're going to take that to the 50 because that gives you completion. This market coming right back into that area where you have that engulfing candle pushing out of the zone. So, yeah, I'm going to take that 138 and be happy and fine with that. Yep. Okay. All right. Anybody got any other questions before I let you guys go?
Yeah. I have a question.
Mm-hmm.
Is this, well, since once you create your zones, it seems to me that you can basically just continue to use those zones for, I guess, forever. You know what I mean? Instead of just, you know, doing it again. You know, at a different time of day. I mean, is that reasonable?
Yeah. I mean, here's the deal. when you set your zones, now typically I like to do it on the higher time frame first and foremost. You know what I mean? To set the high and set the low and then start marking up your zones based upon that.
Right.
You can literally just go and leave that be and just wait until the market moves into those particular zones and then take your trade. Gotcha.
Okay.
You really don't have to mark up anything else because the market is always going to come back to that 50% line all the time.
Right.
And it's always going to go from one zone to the next. That's it.
Okay.
That's it.
One more thing, too. This is probably going to be off. When we started using the ratios, what came to my mind is with the head and shoulders. When you trap a candlestick on the left shoulder, you know said that you know you can place two bids where you trap the candle, right?
You said. Okay, I'm a little confused.
Okay. On the head and shoulders. Once the left shoulder is identified, and then the head develops, and then it will trace 100% back to the neckline. Once that happens, you can go to your left shoulder and identify the highest candle.
Correct.
And you trap it. You trap it, right?
Right.
Once you trap it, that's where you can identify your order, correct?
Correct. Yeah.
Now.
Go ahead.
So now with the ratio, is it still valid to place two orders or just one?
It's completely up to you.
Okay.
That's completely up to you how many orders you decide to actually put in. Now, for those who may not know necessarily what you're referring to, some time ago, Orin actually showed us, you know, the head and shoulder pattern and basically showed us, you know, a way to take advantage of that. So looking at the market, typically what happens is you have your left shoulder that's formed, you got to pull back, then the market actually drops, and then she comes back up past your previous high. The market comes back down into that area which you had your left shoulder. Now, what I've formulated is a zone. I use that one candle that produces the lowest wick, okay, in that left shoulder, or the highest width in that left shoulder. Now, this one is too much of a zone for me, okay? So what I would do is just bring this down and trap the wick of that particular candle, okay? Now, notice, market pushed up, pushed right back down past there, came up, okay? Clearing our left shoulder's pullback, all right? Just cleared it all together. This is your neckline. The market cleared that completely. And then what did she do? She pushed right back down into that zone. And this is where I would take my trade. This here will be my first order. Okay. And then this one will be my second order. Come on here. Yeah, just get in there. Get in there. She's not respecting me. There we go. Oops, whatever. That'll be my second order. And then down here at the bottom, this would be my stop loss. Okay? That would be my stop loss. Now, I'm going to tell you now, everybody's not going to see this. Everybody's not going to see this. Everybody's not necessarily going to grasp this. Okay? So, this is something that, you know what I mean, I had been working with Warren with, and it worked very, very well, but people weren't really grasping onto it themselves. So I wanted to actually give people something a little bit more simplistic that you can understand. You can grab on very, very easy, and then get your money. But essentially, technique works. As long as you can see the head and shoulder pattern, it clears your previous high. Market's going to come back down into that zone and then take advantage and get you your money. So how would you actually use your risk and reward? It's simple. Your first entry. Okay, and I think we, Orin just basically goes 25 pips. Me, I like to use measured moves. So I would basically, from the neckline to the shoulder, I mean, to the head. And all I'm doing is just basically moving this bad boy up, okay? Love to go half the distance, or I can go the full distance. But we're gonna just shoot for half the distance. And essentially, this is all you're doing. I believe that's half the distance right about there. So we're gonna bring that down just a tad bit. So this will be your chart, your entry number two. This one will be your entry number one. And you basically just doing the same thing. That's it. And you see both of them pretty much hit your target. You would have got your money. All right. Now this one would have been a 1-2 risk to reward, but this one would have been a 1-4. Right. If that market actually came down and hit your second entry there.
Okay. All right. Okay. All right. Okay. So I said, yeah, okay. You can still
do the double.
Okay. All right, cool.
Yeah. Okay. All right, guys, it is 4:19. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna let you guys go. So you can go ahead and enjoy the rest of your Sunday. All right. So let you guys go. I'm gonna go ahead and get this processed. Get it out on the one Facebook group so you guys can take advantage of it. All right. So love you much, and I'll see you guys on the next go around.
All right. Thanks again, man.
Thanks, Dan.
Thanks.
No problem, guys.
Thank you.
Thanks, Dan.
Yep.